Hi guys, Duke of the Bump here yet again. Thought I'd bring you a classic this time. I'll be playing Halo for the Atari 2600. This is, of course, the predecessor to what's become pretty much the biggest game franchise ever. I don't know, Call of Duty might have a beat at this point, but still, you know, unfortunately these days, when people say video games, you know, Halo's probably one of the first things they think of. But, you know, a lot of people don't know that it all started, you know, way back in 1983 on the humble Atari 2600. This was one of the last games released for the console, and I'll take you through. This is basically the prologue to the Halo story. This is Planet Halo, where we are now, and this green character is, of course, Mr. Chief, the protagonist of the Halo series. This is a moment when Mr. Chief first gets his pistol, the infamous Halo pistol. Your mission is basically to explore the planet and defend yourself against any of the aliens that you happen to encounter. They're called the Revenants. That one is the weakest Revenant. It's known as the Pawn. These guys, you know, their shots are slow, their AI is inferior to the other aliens. They're just the basic, you know, Goombas of the game. Along the way, you will find a few power-ups. There's one right there. That's the shield. You pick that up, that'll protect you against one hit. You can find other shields laying around, but they don't, their effect does not stack, unfortunately. So, one hit, no matter how many shields you pick up. That gray alien that I just killed is one of the superior Revenants. We'll be meeting quite a few of them. I don't know what these things are, but if you touch them, they kill you, so stay away from them. They look kind of like traffic cones with flashing hamburgers on them. I don't know, it's the Atari, so you kind of have to use your imagination. That was the deal back then. You know, I really don't understand why this game wasn't more popular. I mean, this is pretty groundbreaking for an Atari 2600 game in quite a few ways. I mean, the fact that it even has any sort of enemy AI is like, you know, a milestone in video game history. I mean, as, you know, as primitive as it might be. Yeah, this game only sold a couple thousand copies, so it's extremely rare. I'm playing on an emulator, of course. I don't own a copy of this. But, if you're one of the few who do, you know, you're sitting on a treasure that is worth a pretty penny. Oh, crap. Whew. Three swarms of superior Revenants. We made it through without taking a scratch. And that's the first pistol upgrade. It allows you to fire, well, faster, basically. Firing rate is still the same, one bullet on the screen per time, but it is a vastly superior weapon to the other one. Some more of those hamburger cones. Whoa! Let's see, I don't want to try to... I know if I try to go through those, I'm going to touch them and get hit, so... There we go. Notice how the position changes every time you re-enter the screen. I don't know if that's intentional, or if it's just one of the side effects of, you know, a low memory buffer for the 2600. Oh, I just got hit, but fortunately there were two more shields there. These guys are slightly better versions of the Pawn. Well, quite better versions. Their gun is on par with our upgraded gun. And I just lost my first life. Luckily, when you respawn, you start with a shield, so the game's a little forgiving in that respect. So yeah, you guys may be wondering, ooh, there's a nasty superior revenant there. You guys may be wondering where I've been. I know it's been a while, but I have a new job, and my horrible job was the main thing preventing me from LPing and streaming before. Unfortunately, one of the things that hasn't changed is the amount of overtime I've been working. This is the wrong way, actually. I want to go up. Yeah, my new job is way better. Oh, crap. Ice area. My new job is way better than my old job, but for the next couple months, I'll still be working a significant amount of overtime, which is good and bad. It's good because I'll be making some relatively serious bank for me. I don't know if these igloos hurt you or not. I never try touching them. I wouldn't recommend it. But yeah, that's mainly what's been going on in my life. Let's see, there should be a key around here somewhere. I think I called one of those other enemies a superior revenant instead of... It was actually something else. Apologies if I get the nomenclature wrong. I'm not too versed in the Halo universe. This game is actually pretty unique for the Atari 2600 in that there's no score counter at all. And I think this is the only Atari 2600 game not to have some sort of scorekeeping method. I don't know, maybe Adventure didn't have one. But it's pretty rare to have a game on the system whose only purpose is to be beaten. You know, from beginning to end, there's no high score to strive for. That was, superior. Uh-oh. I got hit. It's okay. Should be another shield around here somewhere. Okay, the last key we picked up, there was a barrier here that had opened. And I'm not sure what's going on. Like, the sprites are wider than... I mean, this looks like the area you started in, but the trees are wider, and the revenant sprites are wider. I don't get it. I'm not sure this is a glitch, or... Or what? Honestly, this is the first time I've ever made it this far. I didn't expect to be doing this well on this playthrough. That is really weird. Why does everything look so funky? Well, the key looks normal anyway. Let's see where we need to go next. I'm actually doing pretty well to have only lost one... There's no point in doing this, but why not? To have only lost one life by this point. Oh, and we're back in the ice area? That doesn't make any sense. Whoa. See if there's an easier way to... There we go. I don't want to risk touching those. Most things in this game kill you when you touch them. The trees don't, but I think those are the only things that don't. Oh, man. I do not like these guys. Oh, boy. Oh, crap. It was an ambush. Okay, we're down to our last hit with no shields. And that's it for this one. Let's see if I can get back there, and I'll try to finish the game up for you. This has been Duke of the Bump. Thanks for watching Let's Play Halo, and hopefully another video should be going up fairly soon. Bye.